In the next series of lectures, we're going to discuss a technique that is used in organic chemistry known as proton NMR spectroscopy. Now, proton NMR spectroscopy uses a principle that comes from nuclear physics known as nuclear magnetic resonance. So, before we understand what proton NMR spectroscopy is, we first have to understand what nuclear magnetic resonance is. So, recall that protons have a certain amount of positive charge, and that positive charge can spin in one of two ways. So, let's suppose this is our proton. Now, if the proton's electric charge spins in this direction, it creates a magnetic dipole moment that points in this direction, and this is known as a spin up, and it has a value of positive 1/2. On the other hand, if the electric charge spins in the reverse direction, if it spins this way, in that case, it also creates a magnetic dipole moment, but this magnetic dipole moment points along an opposite axis. It points this way. So basically, anytime we take a magnetic dipole moment and we place it inside an external magnetic field, that external magnetic field will align the magnetic dipole moment along the same axis as that magnetic field. So that means when we take our proton and we place it inside our external magnetic field, the magnetic dipole moment of that proton will align itself along the same direction as the magnetic field. So to see exactly what we mean, let's take a look at diagram A and diagram B. So, in diagram A, we have 6 different protons, and each one of these protons has its own spin. So, basically, when there is no external magnetic field, in the absence of any external magnetic field, the magnetic dipole moment of each one of our protons is oriented in some random direction. And basically, the energy of each one of our protons is exactly the same. They're all found on the same energy level. Now, each one of these protons can either spin in a positive 1/2 manner or in a negative 1/2 manner. They can either spin up or spin down. Now, when we place these into an external magnetic field, let's suppose we turn on that external magnetic field that is constant and points, let's say, in the positive direction along the y-axis. Now, what happens is this magnetic field will orient the magnetic dipole moment given by these black arrows along the same direction as the magnetic field lines. But because we have 2 different types of spins, we see that the orientation of these spins will be different. So what happens is these protons that spin in the positive 1/2 manner, that have a positive 1/2 spin, will basically orient along the same direction as the magnetic field. So they will orient as shown in this diagram, and they will decrease in energy and become more stable because they point in the same direction. However, those protons that spin in the opposite direction, whose electric charge spins in the opposite direction, their magnetic dipole moment will orient along the same direction, but it will oppose the direction of our magnetic field. That is, it will point not up but downward, and that means the energy level of these protons will not decrease but increase. So once again, when no magnetic field is applied, the protons all have the same exact energy values and cannot be distinguished by their proton spins. However, when we apply a constant external magnetic field B0, those protons with a spin of positive 1/2, the spin up also given by alpha, will align along the same direction as the magnetic field and will become more stable. stable and will decrease in energy. However, those protons that have a spin of negative 1/2, known as the spin down or the beta spin, these will align against our field, meaning they will not point in the same direction, but will point in the opposite direction. So they will increase in energy and will become less stable. So basically, in this case, in the absence of any field, they have the same energy, but once we apply the field, they split. And they split as a result of the two different types of proton spins that they can have. So some of them spin down, some of them spin up. The spin up are lower in energy, the spin down are higher in energy. And this difference in energy is given by the following equation that comes from nuclear physics. So the difference in energy between these two energy quantum states is given by taking the difference between this energy and this energy. So this is the energy of the beta spin, the beta protons, and this is the energy of the alpha protons. Now, from nuclear physics, we know that this is equal to 2 multiplied by a constant known as the Bohr magneton, multiplied by this applied external magnetic field B0. So we see that as we increase the magnetic field, we increase the difference in energy between these two states. So for a higher magnetic field, there is a greater separation between our two quantum energy states. So, let's suppose once we flip on our magnetic field B, we have a separation, and now we somehow want to get these protons with a positive 1/2 spin to transition to this higher in energy spin. How exactly can we go about allowing these protons in the lower quantum state to jump up to the higher energy quantum state? Well, one way we can do it is by giving these protons enough energy. So basically, we can direct electromagnetic waves with just the right frequency and just the right energy that matches this energy difference. And if we direct those electromagnetic waves at these protons, and that electromagnetic wave has the right frequency, these protons will gain energy and will transition to the higher in energy quantum state. So once again, if we now direct electromagnetic waves in the radio region known as radio frequency waves at the spin up these protons, the spin up protons can gain enough energy to transition to the higher in energy level spin down quantum states. So basically, we take our radio frequency electromagnetic wave shown by the squiggly line, we direct it at our proton. If the frequency is just right, what happens is this proton will gain that energy and will transition to the higher in energy quantum state given by this type of negative 1/2 spin. Now, as soon as it transitions, it can then lose that energy and go back down to the ground state, this state. And when that takes place, it will release that photon of energy that carries that specific frequency, and we can now monitor this energy released, and this will give us our difference in energy. So once again, if we take the radio frequency wave, the electromagnetic radiation, with just the right frequency and direct it at all these protons, they will all transition to this higher in energy state. And when they go back down, they release that energy, and we can collect and monitor that release and energy. And using this equation, we can determine what the frequency of our wave must be. So once again, if the difference in energy, delta E, between the two states for any magnetic field B0 is given by this equation, then to calculate the frequency that this wave must carry, we simply equate the energy of the wave, the photon of radiation given by H times F, where H is Planck's constant and F is the frequency of oscillation of the radio frequency wave, if we equate this to this delta E energy to the Bohr magneton time this, we can solve for the frequency, and we find that the frequency of this particular wave that is absorbed by this particular proton is given by this equation. Now, what is the meaning of this frequency? Well, the radio frequency wave, this incoming radiation, must oscillate with just the right frequency, must carry just the right energy to cause the proton to transition between our energy states. And when the proton gains the energy, the proton is said to resonate. And for this reason, this frequency is known as the resonance frequency. So in physics, we usually use the term resonance frequency, but in chemistry, we usually say the chemical shift. So the chemical shift is the resonance frequency, which is basically the frequency of our wave. It's the frequency with which our proton and this electromagnetic wave basically oscillates as it goes from this to this region. So, how exactly is this related to organic chemistry? So basically, the majority of the organic compounds and molecules found in organic chemistry consist of the hydrogen atom. And the hydrogen atom contains a single proton in the nucleus and no neutrons. So that basically means that we can imagine the hydrogen atom as simply being a single proton. And we can apply this principle to these hydrogen atoms found inside the molecule to basically study our hydrogen atoms inside the molecule. So, most organic molecules consist of hydrogen atoms, which has only one proton in the nucleus. Now, by placing a hydrogen containing molecule inside a proton NMR spectrometer, we can basically determine and study all the different hydrogens that are found in a molecule. Now, basically, if we examine our hydrogen atoms individually by themselves, we see that all these individual hydrogen atoms under the same exact magnetic field will produce the same exact change in energy and will have the same exact chemical shift values. However, the hydrogen atoms found in molecules actually have different chemical shifts, and that's because if we actually examine the molecule, the organic molecule that contains the carbon and hydrogen atoms, we see that each hydrogen atom is found in a region with a different electron density, and so because each hydrogen is found in a different electron density, that means it will be found within a region that has a different magnetic field. And because the magnetic field determines our energy and determines our frequency, which is the chemical shift, we see that protons in molecules that are found on different locations will show different chemical shifts. And in this manner, we can basically determine or differentiate between the different hydrogens found inside any given molecule. And we're going to discuss that in much greater detail in the next lecture. So basically, the electrons found around the nuclei inside any given organic molecule can change the magnetic field around a given hydrogen proton. This means that different magnetic field values of those different hydrogen protons will basically produce different chemical shifts because the chemical shift, our frequency value, depends on our magnetic field B naught.